Hello YouTube Dog Commerce, my name is Valentin and I'm from DM Trading Bulgaria. In today's vlog I'm going to speak more about yield curve and yield curve inversion. I'm going to try to simplify it for you what is it and what you can expect on the markets. This inversion is a moment that actually the bond market was expecting since the last maybe 12 months. The strangest thing here is that there is no catalyst, it happens basically from nothing, and most people are trying to figure out what they can expect from this. The last time when it happens was during 2005, and that was the first thing that indicates that the recession is coming, and now of course a lot of people are thinking the same. Of course nobody says that the recession is coming on the way tomorrow, but it's an indicator that probably it's going to happen soon. Last time when it happens it took to the markets 2 years to get into a real recession, so this time of course it depends what's going to happen and how the Federal Reserve is going to react, but probably we expect in the recent 1 or maybe 2 years something major to happen and have an event that is going to cause a big correction on the markets, which we're going to call a recession. What is yield curve inversion? Well, in a simple language, that is when the spread between short-term bonds and long-term bonds goes below zero. What actually happens in our case, this was last week, the 3- and 5-year treasury yield crosses and went below zero, marking the first inversion in a decade. In case some of you wonder how all of this is represented on a graph, I prepared for you an example which I took from Bloomberg. As you can see from the graph, first I'm going to explain you, the light line is representing the spread between 3- and 5-year treasury, the purple one is representing the spread between 2- and 5-year treasury, and the blue one, the blue line, is representing the spread between 2 and 10. As you can see, this is the period that we spoke about. This is 2006 and 2007, that was the beginning of the previous recession. As you can see here, the yield between short-term and long-term treasury was inversing again, and that was actually the catalyst which later on pushed the world to went into a recession. And now actually what you can see is that the graph is representing quite the same thing. However, here we can speak about something that didn't happen last time. Now maybe a lot of people are wondering why the spread between 3- and 5-year treasury went below zero before the one between 7 and 10, because earlier this year the spread inversion between 7- and 10-year treasury note was looking like the most probable scenario. Well, maybe one of the biggest reasons is that the Federal Reserve balance sheet reduction has putting a lot of pressure on the 10-year note compared to the one with shorter maturity, and that was definitely not the case during the previous recession in 2007 and 2008. That would be all for this short vlog. If you have other questions regarding this topic, you can always drop me a line on my official DM Trading email. You can find it on our official website and on the contact list there. And of course, if you like this video, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you very much for your attention and I'll see you again next time. Bye bye.